We have the list of 20 Republicans who voted against the GOP budget bill. On Thursday, President Donald Trump scored a major legislative win when the House voted on the Senate budget proposal, and it actually passed. The bill passed by 216-212, a razor-thin margin. All Democrats voted against the bill, no surprise there, and 20 Republicans actually joined them in voting against it, the Daily Caller reported. The Republicans who voted against the bill ranged in location. Many of them were from the East Coast, like New York State, but others were from more traditionally conservative districts, which was somewhat shocking. According to the Daily Caller, the list consisted of Justin Amash of Michigan, Ken Buck of Colorado, Dan Donovan of New York, John Duncan of Tennessee, John Faso of New York, and Brian Fitzpatrick of Pennsylvania. Matt Gaetz of Florida, Lynn Jenkins of Kansas, Walter B. Jones of North Carolina, John Katko of New York, Pete King of New York, Leonard Lentz of New Jersey, Frank Lobianto of New Jersey, Tom MacArthur of New Jersey, Thomas Massey of Kentucky, Mark Sanford of South Carolina, Chris Smith of New Jersey, Elise Stefanik of New York, Claudia Tenney of New York, and Lee Zeldin of New York. Here are the Republican representatives who voted no. Justin Amash of Michigan. Ken Buck of Colorado. Dan Donovan of New York. John Duncan of Tennessee. John Faso of New York. Brian Fitzpatrick of Pennsylvania. Matt Gaetz of Florida. Lynn Jenkins of Kansas. Walter B. Jones of North Carolina. John Katko of New York. Pete King of New York. Leonard Lentz of New Jersey. Frank Lobianto of New Jersey. Tom MacArthur of New Jersey. Thomas Massey of Kentucky. Mark Sanford of South Carolina. Chris Smith of New Jersey. Elise Stefanik of New York. Claudia Tenney of New York. Lee Zeldin of New York. Passing this budget bill was the key to passing tax reform because the budget contained language allowing the Senate to use budget reconciliation to pass tax reform. Under budget reconciliation, a bill only needs a simple majority, 51, to pass the Senate. The Republicans have a 52-seat majority. Now all they need to do is get their act together and show that they are capable of actually getting a majority together to vote on something meaningful, something they have yet to do well. The Washington Post noted that the fact that the budget vote was so close has some people worried that once the draft of the tax reform legislation is released, the divides within the GOP will grow even more. The Washington Examiner reported that the 20 Republicans who voted against the bill did so for a number of reasons. Some were fiscal hawks who didn't want to pass a budget that wasn't balanced. Others were from states like New York and aren't too thrilled about state and local tax deductions being scrapped because their state taxes are among the highest in the nation. Hopefully, Republicans will now be able to actually get behind tax reform and move forward. This is something that needs to be done by the end of the year. If Republicans can't even agree on lowering taxes, then the party might as well just resign en masse right now and hand control back over to the Democrats. Everything is on the line right now. Share this story on Facebook and Twitter and let us know your reaction to what these Republicans did.